An economics application, elasticity of demand. Our goals are to find the elasticity of demand function, find the maximum of a total revenue function, and characterize demand in terms of elasticity. Retailers and manufacturers often need to know how a small change in price will affect the demand for a product. For example, if a small increase in price produces no change in demand, a price increase will increase revenue. If a small increase in price creates a drop in demand, the increase will probably decrease revenue. In order to measure the sensitivity of demand to an increase in price, we use what's called elasticity of demand. The elasticity of demand, E, is given as a function of price X by elasticity of X is equal to negative X times the derivative of the demand function divided by the demand function. This formula can be derived from the ratio of the percent change in quantity to the percent change in price, which I will show on the next slide. Now, these next three components are the most important ideas you need to be familiar with when we talk about elasticity. The total revenue is increasing at those X values for which the elasticity is less than 1. Demand is inelastic. An increase in price will bring an increase in revenue. If demand is inelastic, then revenue is increasing. Total revenue is decreasing at those X values for which the elasticity is greater than 1. Demand is elastic. An increase in price will bring a decrease in revenue. If demand is elastic, then revenue is decreasing. Total revenue is maximized at the values for which E of X is equal to 1. Demand is unit elastic. The demand has unit elasticity when revenue is at a maximum. Here's kind of the derivation of the elasticity formula. I'm not going to go through all this. You may want to pause the video and make sure this makes sense to you, but this is how you can derive the elasticity formula, starting with the ratio of the percent change in quantity to the percent change in price. Let's take a look at some of the price elasticities in the U.S. economy. On top, we have items listed that are elastic demands, and below we have inelastic demands. Remember, when E is greater than 1, an increase in price will bring a decrease in revenue. So for example, if we take a look at furniture listed at 1.26, we're saying if there's an increase in price, revenue will decrease. Probably because if the price of furniture goes too high, we will stop buying it or we'll buy less of it. Down below, when we have inelastic demand, for example, clothing and housing, those are items where if the price goes up, we're still going to have to purchase them. We have to have clothes, we have to have a place to live. That's why if the price increases, you can expect an increase in revenue. Remember that revenue is maximized when the elasticity is equal to 1. So you can see the items here that are very close to the value of 1. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at a couple examples. A company found the demand for its product to be Q equals D of X, which is equal to 400 minus X. Find the elasticity function. Okay, so let's go ahead and write our elasticity function again. So we have it here. So it's negative X times the derivative of the demand function divided by the demand function. Okay, so for this problem, it's a pretty straightforward one. We have negative X times the derivative of the demand function, which we can see here would be negative 1, divided by the demand function, 400 minus X. Simplifying, notice we have X in the numerator and 400 minus X in the denominator. Find the elasticity at the price X equals 124. Determine if demand is elastic or inelastic and interpret. So we need to find the elasticity when X is 124. Pretty straightforward. I've already calculated this value to save time. It's 0.449. So the conclusion here is, the conclusion is that demand is inelastic, which means if we increase price, I'm going to use some abbreviations here, if we increase price, we can expect to have an increase in revenue. We could also say that revenue is increasing. Find the price or value of X for which revenue is a maximum. Remember that revenue is maximized when elasticity is equal to 1. So what we can do is set our elastic function equal to 1 and solve. There's our elasticity function. If we set it equal to 1 and solve, there's several ways of doing this. I'm going to go ahead and put 1 over 1, and then I'll do cross product. So I have X must equal 400 minus x times 1, 400 minus x. Solving this equation, I'd add x to both sides, 2x is equal to 400, dividing by 2, we can see that x will equal 200. So the price should be set at $200 to maximize revenue. As you can see from part B, when it was $124, it was inelastic, meaning we should increase price, and in fact we should increase it to $200.